everyone. I'm Larry Ridley. Welcome to the NFL on EA Sports. The Falcons come into today's game looking for a way to pick up win number 10 on the season. It's the Chiefs going up against the Falcons. So let's get over to the ATL, Atlanta. Standing by our commentary team, Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
In its final season now as an NFL stadium, there's a look inside the Georgia Dome in downtown Atlanta. Today, we've got a Week 13 matchup for you here between the Kansas City Chiefs and the Atlanta Falcons. Hello again, everyone. Brandon Gordon along with Charles Davis. And Charles, we take a look at this Falcons team as they interplay. They come in playing pretty good football, winners of four of their last six games. Meanwhile, for the visitors here, the Chiefs, it's late in the year. We all know it. We've seen the calendar for these guys. Their bodies could probably use a break, but they have to push on.
And they're...
First down, it's Lynch. He's got time in the pocket. Oh, he had 6 points in his hands there. Couldn't hang on. Second down. Long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field.
After all the preparation, all the practice, a play like that will absolutely break your heart. They had everything they wanted, just unable to complete it. In the end zone, a big-time drop.
And that's incomplete. Nelson Aguilar, the intended receiver, and it's third down. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. And let's see, six defensive backs out there. They're in a dime here on third and goal. Lynch with it on third and goal. Surveying the field. And that is caught for the touchdown, Kansas City. Their dangerous wide receiver with his first career NFL touchdown. And the Chiefs are going to take a first quarter lead. Because the booth, they see something that they want to take another peek at to find out if this was a touchdown or not. They had to go to the monitor, get an extra look. That's what the technology is for, and this touchdown will count. Here's Ryan, and his throw here is incomplete. The target that time was Vincent Jackson, and that'll bring up second down.
How many times when we see an incomplete pass, we just look at the receiver and say, ah, should have caught that one. That was a drop, and we just put it on the offense. How about a little credit for the defense there? They just forced an incompletion.
Yeah, especially after starting in a tough spot defensively, but a good start there on first down.
That gave them a little extra confidence there, starting, as you said, in a tough spot and being able to make a play on first down.
So a third and 10, and defensively, a dime look, six DBs. They'll run it here. This is Buck Allen. Just a gain of two there, and it's going to bring up a fourth down. So out comes the field goal team now for the second time here today. He hit his first. Now this from 43. And Tucker's kick right there. It's good. And they'll get it back within a point at 7-6. One back is Lacy. He'll get it running right. A strong running. Officially no gain on the play, and it's second down. Wasn't able to get anything, no gain. Fumbled once already. Maybe he's being a little careful. Not necessarily on that play, but I'm sure that's in his mind somewhere.
Oh, without a doubt, because protecting the football is job one for anyone who's carrying it, and that's exactly what he tried to do on that play, but it didn't gain him any yardage. In so many ways, throwing the hitch route is actually one of the safer things an offense can do. Get the ball out to the receiver as fast as possible, hope he's got man-to-man coverage, and hope that his athleticism wins on the perimeter.
And he couldn't hang on to it through the contact. Incomplete. So now here comes the field goal team for the third time today.
Whenever I see an in route dropped, as we just saw in that play, I'm always thinking that in the back of their mind, they're worried about what's coming at them because they're going towards traffic on that route as opposed to being away from it and maybe having a little bit more space.
On first down, throwing middle, but it's incomplete. Second and 10, it's Lynch again over the middle, and it's It's incomplete. 10 yards to go on third. Catch there. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. From the red zone now, here's Lynch on first down. That is caught at the 7. And eventually brought down, but it's near the 5 at the 6. And quickly, they get to the line. Lynch to throw. This will be caught at about the 5. 5 yards on the catch there brings up second down. And the 8th play on this drive coming up. Throwing again here, Lynch. That's caught at the 1. And he will take it on in for a Chiefs touchdown. DeAndre Washington is... Still about 3 yards shy of a first as the 4-yard pickup brings it to third down. So they run it on second down. Now let's see what third down brings here for the offense.
Well, if you're a football guy, that's a pretty run because everyone is in sync right there. Obviously, the guy carrying the ball, but how about the people up front? Leverage, athleticism, they created some nice space for him.
The ball's still a few inches shy of the marker after the 3-yard run, so now a little soul searching on fourth down. And the 10-year vet knocks it through the goalpost, and that'll push the lead up to 8. So the drive's... first down, Ryan. And the Chiefs are going to get him. It's the first time Pro Bowler from a year ago, Ziggy Ansah, in there to get him. And that's sack number six for him on the year.
Well, the beauty of screen passes is they take a little time to develop, and they can often hit big, but sometimes they take too long to develop, and sometimes you get sacked.
Yeah, what's perfectly called for a defense to attack a screen?
Typically a blitz, and even though people think that the screen operates against the blitz, if you have the blitz called and you still cover the screen, now that allows your blitzers to get there.
Third and long, it's Ryan finding time. Walker with a grab, left side. Good defense holds him to only a yard, and it'll be fourth down.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. On the left hash, this from 48 yards. And Tucker's kick right there, it's good. And that'll get the lead down to five. So an interesting call there. Second down, Washington. And all the way down inside the five to the four. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal.
Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense.
Hurry up, here we go. Three, nine, five.
From the shotgun, it's Lynch. He's got time. And his throw is incomplete. A long drive here, play 12 coming up for the offense. Lynch looking to throw on second. He's got time in the pocket. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down.
Let's face it, you can run the route tree as many times as you want, get in sync, practice it, do all those things. But once you get to game speed, it doesn't always time up quite that well. That one goes incomplete.
And that one drops incomplete as he got popped as he was throwing it.
So on fourth down, out trots the kicker in a big spot here. This will be just a 21-yard attempt. And Novak's kick is good. And that'll push the lead up to eight. So, Charles, I think from a defensive perspective, you have to look at that field goal there and consider it a win.
You were able to keep them within a touchdown, so no question about it. That was the kind of stand that keeps you in ball games.
And he'll be brought down at the 23, make it the 24-yard line.
Atlanta now coming out on the field. And last time able to get three.
It's not what they wanted. They wanted six, but they got at least something. They mustered something out of the drive.
They'll take it. Just I like the way you've described it. Not ideal, but they'll take it. Anything to put some points on the board. But this time on offense, they don't even want to see the field goal kicker trot on the field. They want that ball in the end zone.
Yeah, they'll be going for six. Again on second and 10, it's Ryan. And he slings one that's incomplete. He was trying to hit Taylor Gabriel that time. And it's third down. So here we go now. An extra defensive back in there on third and 10. On third down, Ryan. And now another one thrown incomplete. One of his main targets, Delaney Walker, the intended receiver. And now it's fourth down.
That's going to go in the books as a 55-yard punt. Well done. And it's Chiefs football, first and 10. Here's the Kansas City offense now as they get set to take over. And last time they got 3 points, but it was a chip shot field goal. And when you go to the sideline after a chip shot field goal, maybe the offense not too happy.
It's a balancing act, isn't it? Because you're exactly right. They're none too pleased that they didn't punch it in for 6 points. But they also have to remember, they did put points on the board.
3 points is 3 points.
And in this league, you take points when you can get them. Not easily done.
Going right back to Smallwood. He can't bring him down.
The weight room does work.
No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd-and-9 situation. Time for a break. So the Chiefs in possession of the ball as we welcome you back. They're facing a critical 3rd down now as they try to hold on to this lead. On 3rd down, here's Washington. And he's going to get to the 31, enough for the 1st down. And now a timeout defensively by the Falcons. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages.
3, 39.
Lynch is going to throw it. Surveying the field. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. No gain there on the completion, 2nd and 10. And the Falcons going to use another timeout. And now following that timeout, the defense back out onto the field.
Here we go now, 3, 19.
On 2nd down, Smallwood. No, bottled up, fumble. It's out, it's loose. And his guys are going to get the football at the 23-yard line.
The psychology of the game never ceases to amaze me, because you would think there would never be a fumble from what we hear from coaches all the time, right?
And how much they practice not fumbling.
Practice it, preach it, talk about it all the time. You would think no one would ever turn it over. Yet there are humans out there running around, and we just saw another one.
Opportunistic by the defense. And now they're in the hurry up. He'll look to throw. This will be caught at about the 5. A gain of 6 there on 1st. They'll look to throw. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up 3rd down.
Let's face it, perfection is something we all chase, whether it's playing this game or whatever we do.
And he is into the end zone for a Falcon touchdown. Vincent Jackson, his 4th touchdown on the year. And now the Falcons are within a 2-point conversion of tying up the game.
And there's the touchdown, partner. We just saw it. What do you do now? Oh, yeah, of course you know what you do. You're going for 2, right?
I think anytime you're inside of 2 minutes in this situation, you try for 2.
And remember, let's go back to training camp. Every team we talk to said they spend more time now on 2-point conversion periods than they ever have before.
And he'll elect not to return this one, so they'll bring it out to the 25 on the touchback. And the Chiefs now getting set to go. They've got work to do, but they do still have a bit of time here.
And they've got to feel comfortable with that, but they have all their play sequences called. They get out of bounds, that allows them to huddle and call.
Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. Lynch to throw. Finding time. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. That'll leave him with just 1 remaining in this 4th quarter of play. Now it's Lynch. Incomplete. And as the 4th quarter winds down here, we're all even.
And no one wants this game to extend. They want to go ahead and win it right now.
On the give, this is Washington. And the hole closes quickly. He gets it across the 35 to the 36-yard line. 4 yards on the pickup there, but it's going to take him to 4th down.
We always like to talk about defense in terms of levels. 1st-level defensive line, 2nd-level linebackers, 3rd-level defensive backs. On that run, that was what we call a 1st-level run, and it was stopped by a 2nd-level player.
Well, the entire 2015 season featured no ties in the National Football League, but we get one here in the 2016 season, don't we?
Yeah, and it's really odd because to go through...
And here in overtime, if the team that receives the ball scores a touchdown, it's over. If they don't, we can still have some more football.
That's exactly right. If they go down and kick a field goal, the other team gets a possession to either match it or score a touchdown to win the ball game. If both teams kick field goals, the next team to score wins. But if the receiving team throws a pick six or fumbles the ball and it gets picked up by the defense and they score, the game is over at that point.
The Chiefs defense making their way back onto the field. Last drive, touchdown surrendered. Here, see if they can stop them.
It's always a constant battle of letting the last series go, good or bad, but especially bad. Give up a touchdown, okay, forget the finger pointing, forget the blame. Go back out and play the defense you know you're capable of and help your team out.
And probably look to the leaders, as always.
As always. They're going to be the ones going to grab some people and say, all right, let's do this thing.
And he'll be brought down right at the 30 here. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down.
But one thing I'm seeing in this game today, someone watched last week's game tape and made a pact that we're not going to be the ones to take the beating that the last defense did. And they've really held him down in a big way.
What have you seen, maybe just devoting an extra guy or two to him?
I think it's that. I think it's a changeup in coverages, and I just think there's a determination that he's not going to make big plays against them. Even when he's been able to catch the ball, has been able to turn into big-time damage downfield. Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision, and receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
Yeah, give him 4 yards there. It'll be second and six.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
He's got time. Oh, there's that man again. It's complete. And he gets this one all the way down inside the 15. A good pick up there, 26 yards in the red zone this time.
One of the selling points of the in route is it gives the quarterback a really nice sight line to his receiver and almost on a direct shot able to throw the ball into the middle of the field and have a great chance of success as they did on that play.
This will be caught just inside the 10. And he couldn't quite get there. Tackled down at the 1.
And when you're playing a quarterback with some experience and some moxie, you enter the danger zone when you decide to blitz him, because if he's able to diagnose as he did on that play, he can hurt you downfield.
And he's into the end zone for the touchdown and the game winner in OT. Back on day one, they said they were capable of winning 10 games this year. They said that in this locker room. They were right. This makes it an even 10.
And typically, if you win 10, it puts you right in the hunt for the playoffs. It doesn't ensure it, but 10 wins, an excellent goal for any team before a season.
So that's a wrap for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gunn, and this has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. For more, check us out at easports.com. It's a win for the Falcons here as we say so long from Atlanta.